What are the steps you need to take to get the world's best fitting scleral contact lenses? I will talk about that in this video. So the first step to getting well-fitted scleral contact lenses is for your doctor to know the exact shape of your sclera or the white part of the eye. So the white part of the eye is, the cornea is in the middle here, and then around the cornea is the white part of the eye. Now, a well-designed scleral contact lens does not touch the cornea. It actually just lands on the white part of the eye around it. So what we do is we want to map out the exact shape of that white part of the eye. So to do that, we'll take an image of a patient looking straight, looking down, looking up, so we can capture more of the surface of the white part of the eye called the sclera. What the software then does is it takes those images and it's able to extrapolate the heights of the eye, the shapes, the valleys and hills of the eye, because everyone is different in order to design a well-fitting contact lens. From then on, what we can do is we take that image and then we can map out what the world's best contact lens might look like based off of the height of your cornea, based off the shape of the white part of the eye. And the software can design a lens that matches your eye one-to-one. So we've essentially scanned your eye, uploaded it digitally, and now we can design a lens to match perfectly. That is step one of designing your best scleral contact lens. The next step you need to do is afterwards, you need to determine what prescription you need in your scleral contact lenses. Because taking a picture of the eye with this device alone doesn't tell you your prescription. So the next step is to actually get a scleral contact lens, put it in the eye, in which case your doctor will actually get a contact lens, usually in their fitting set, to put on the eye to find out how you see. So for instance, they would take a set like this. They'll take a set like this. They probably grab one of these lenses that matches your eye somewhat closely. Know that usually when you put on these trial fitting lenses, the vision is not perfect because it's not necessarily made for you. It's just for them to get a rough ballpark and for them to determine the prescription afterwards. So you'll take one of these trial lenses, put it on the eye at that visit, and then we'll test your vision through the phoropter. Okay, so the next step is, after you've determined the shape of your eye by taking that scleral topography, now we know the design of the shape of the lens we need, but it doesn't tell us the prescription. So after you put on the trial contact lens, what we'll do is we'll have the patient wear the contact lens like Jackie is wearing right now, and then we'll have her look through here and use the phoropter, which is this, to play that game you might all be familiar with. What's better, one or two? What's better, one or two? And that will determine next to prescription for the scleral contact lens. Because the first step is to determine the shape of the lens. The second is to determine the prescription. So one determines how comfortable the lens will be and how well fitting it will be and how healthy it will be for your eyes. The second determines how well you'll see, how well you'll read books, how well you'll drive your car. And that's the visual component. So we need to do both. Shape of the lens, and then the prescription afterwards. Now we're on step three. So remember, step one was the doctor is supposed to take an image of the shape of your eye with a scleral topographer. Ours is the SMAP 3D. So it maps out the shape of the white part of the eye so we can determine what the shape of the lens should be. Step two is after putting on a practice scleral lens from a trial fitting set, they determine the right prescription they needed through a phoropter to find out what the lens can do to give you your best vision. That was step two. Now, step three is they've ordered the lens, it's arrived, and now you're wearing your custom-made lenses. How do you know if it's right for you? The doctor should do two things. First, they should be checking the prescription through the phoropter again to see how well your prescription matches. Well, they need to make some adjustments to that lens prescription so you can see better. Lastly, they should also be checking how the lens fits on the eye. So one of the best ways to find out how the lens fits on the eye is for the doctor to take pictures of how the lens is sitting on the sclera and to map it out in multiple degrees and multiple angles. I'll give you an example here. On the left here, you'll see actually a picture of the patient's eye and the scleral lens on their eye. So we want to document it with videos and with photography, so we can see how the lens is sitting on the eye. Not only should they take an image of it straight ahead, they should also be able to scan the lens on the eye as well. We use a device called the OCT. The OCT can actually show you the lens, how it lands right here. So right, this patient's looking down, we took a picture of the top of the lens, and we can actually see the lens here. This big black thing here on top is the scleral contact lens edge landing on the eye, so we know how much it's touching the eye at that spot. And on the bottom is the eye itself. The sclera is right here. And so by taking these images, we can find out how it's sitting up top. In this example, how it's sitting on the patient's side, the lens is closer to their nose. How the lens is sitting on the eye, on the corner, on the sclera on the side of the eye, closer to your ear. And also, how close is it to touching your cornea when you're looking straight ahead? So this is an example of it straight ahead. What we see here is patient's lens is up top here. These two lines here, that's the lens. A scleral contact lens should not be touching the cornea. It should have some spacing in between the back of the lens and the cornea. In this example, it's about 300 microns of clearance. That's not bad. Maybe we might make it a little bit lower in the future. But know that that's the spacing that we can measure with the device to know that it's clearing the cornea just enough. If it's too much, let's say it's 700 microns or 800 microns, the lens is probably not right for you. They need to decrease it. So they should be measuring again the spacing between the scleral contact lens up top, the spacing in between where the fluid fills the lens, and then the bottom part of is the cornea there. So we should be measuring how the lens is actually sitting on your eye now that they've custom designed it based off of the image of your sclera, based off the prescription, and now we can take pictures of it to find out afterwards the fine tuning. With scleral lenses, it's always a tricky art to fitting scleral contact lens correctly for the doctor and for the patient. It involves a lot of sometimes fine tuning after the initial lens. One of the best ways to fine tune the lens is to take a picture of the lens on the eye and then actually scan where the lens is fitting in relationship to your eye with an OCT device. So the technology that you're looking for is a scleral topography at your eye doctor's office and also OCT images of how the lens is sitting on the eye, as well as the doctor just looking at the lens with a microscope and just subjectively seeing how it's sitting through their physical examination. So those are the steps you need to take to get the world's best scleral lenses that give you the best vision, that don't fog up on you, that you can wear throughout the day comfortably.